Is photographic memory real? This is the big question, isn't it? The short answer is no. While there are tales of people who have photographic memory or perfect long-term memory, they haven't been scientifically tested in a way that actually proves their abilities. But here's a fun fact for you. Every year since 1993, there is an event called the World Memory Championships. These people are masters of remembering things, and none of the winners have ever claimed to have photographic or eidetic memory. There are people who have entered into the World Memory Championships claiming that they have photographic memory, but none of the contestants that do claim that never take home the prize. Getting into the meat of this video, first I want to talk about the scientific version of what photographic memory is, and then I'm going to share a few stories of people who have come very close. So, eidetic memory. What is it? Eidetic memory and photographic memory are often considered to be interchangeable terms, but they do describe two different abilities. What most people associate with photographic memory is often actually eidetic memory. Eidetic memory is the ability to see an image for only a few seconds after its removal, and then to be able to recall that image very vividly. The image stays in a person's mind without the help of mnemonic devices or other tools to help recall details or the arrangements of items in the image. However, this ability only lasts for a few seconds before the brain decides to either send the important parts of the image to short-term memory or to disregard it. Photographic memory, however, is the ability to see an image or a page of text and automatically store it into short-term or long-term memory in great detail. At a moment's notice, a person with photographic memory can recall that image with perfect accuracy. They can read a page of the dictionary word by word without any error. However, this actually never happens. So, eidetic memory is mostly visual and lasts up to 4 to 5 seconds, while the fictional photographic memory lasts a lifetime. But in real life, how often does eidetic memory actually occur? Well, when it comes to eidetic memory, there is one group of people that can reasonably claim to actually have it, and that group is children. Research says up to 15% of children have an eidetic memory, and this number shrinks when we start talking about adults. Most adults who have been labeled as having an eidetic memory also use mnemonics and other memory devices alongside their enhanced natural abilities to help remember imagery. Nobody has ever really had true photographic memories, although there are two notable stories of people who have come very close. First, let's talk about Elizabeth Strohmeyer. Most stories of people with photographic memory come with very sketchy details. Take the story of Charles Strohmeyer III and his student, Elizabeth. Strohmeyer was a Harvard scientist, and in 1970, he made claims that one of his students, Elizabeth, had a photographic memory. So what backed up this claim? Well, Strohmeyer had Elizabeth look at an image of 10,000 dots. The next day, to ensure the dots were stored in her long-term memory, he showed her another 10,000 dots. And whenever you take both of these images of the 10,000 dots and you place them together, they're supposed to form a three-dimensional image that makes sense, but only when both of them are together. This is commonly called a stereogram. When Strohmeyer showed Elizabeth the second image of the 10,000 dots, she could supposedly see the three-dimensional image, showing that she had remembered the first 10,000 dots perfectly and superimposed it on the second one she saw in her brain. So here's a simple example of a stereogram. Charles' test made headlines, but then something really strange happened. He married Elizabeth, and after they were married, they never participated in any further tests of her memory. And although scientists have looked far and wide for a case similar to Elizabeth's, it's never been found. Secondly, let's get on to Solomon Sheroshevsky. While no marriages have tainted the reputation of Solomon, his legitimacy as the man who could not forget has been doubted and tested over the years. Sheroshevsky, more commonly known as S for obvious reasons, became famous for his ability to recite and remember very long strings of numbers at a time. In the 1920s, S was attending a work meeting and told off by a coworker, Alexander Luria, because he wasn't taking any notes. Alexander was mad at him. Anyways, after the meeting was over, S recalled the entire speech of the meeting word by word. They say since then he memorized complex math formulas and large poems in foreign languages. But the picture painted of S wasn't entirely accurate. While he was a phenomenal mnemonist, he did not have a photographic memory. In fact, when reporters followed up on the story of S, they found that his relatives would describe him as forgetful, and he also showed very strong signs of something called five-fold synesthesia, in which his senses were all connected to each other. For example, he might see a number 5, and then feel sandpaper, taste chocolate, and then hear Mozart. His experience of the world most likely helped his memory, because the next time that he tasted chocolate, all the other sensations would come rushing back. Here's a short little example of something he said. Take the number 1. This is a proud, well-built man. 2 is a high-spirited woman. 3 is a gloomy person. 6 is a man with a swollen foot, 7 a man with a mustache, 8 a very stout woman, a sack within a sack. As for number 87, what I see is a fat woman and a man twirling his mustache. So you might be wishing that you had fivefold synesthesia, but you'll be sad to know that reports say that he actually had a very troubled life because of his synesthesia. It actually hindered him from performing a lot of simple life tasks. So as I end this video, you might be wondering, how can you improve your memory? Well, there are many ways to improve your memory, specifically with certain tools called mnemonics, which actually translates to memory devices. I have an entire video on this, so check it out here, or just wait a few days if you're watching this before it's out. I also want to let you know that I just finished creating an online memory quiz that tests your long-term, your short-term, and your working memory in less than 5 minutes. If you'd like to participate in that and see how you compare to other people, there's a link in the description below so you can take it absolutely free. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you learned something, and I'll see you in the next video.